So today we're going to talk about percent yield, and we're going to frame this with thinking about baking brownies. If you were to bake brownies, I want you to think about, would you end up with all of the chocolate that you started with in your brownies at the end? And hopefully these pictures are inspiring you to think, well, no, all of the chocolate wouldn't be in my brownies. Some would be on the side of the bowl, some would be on the spoon. I might lick the spoon. We shouldn't lick the spoon in chemistry, but some of it's going to go away. And that's how I'd like you to think about percent yield in chemistry. Chemical reactions are never perfect. You're not going to get the amount of product that you calculate with stoichiometry. So the percent yield equation says the actual yield divided by the theoretical yield will give us the percent yield. That's the percent you're going to make. The actual yield is the amount of product obtained experimentally. Sometimes we even call this the experimental yield. This is what you actually get if you actually run an experiment. The theoretical yield is the expected amount of the product. This is what you would expect to get by using your periodic table and running a stoichiometry problem. Everything that we do in class, on all the worksheets and stuff, those are all theoretical yields because you're not actually running any of them. Here's an example of what one of these problems might look like. What is the percent yield if 13.1 grams of calcium oxide is actually produced when 24.8 grams of calcium carbonate is heated? So what you're going to do is you're going to start with the calcium carbonate. I want to know how much calcium oxide theoretically should I produce if I start with 24 grams of calcium carbonate. Convert that to moles, moles to moles. Make sure everything cancels, moles into grams, and what you end up with is that theoretically, you should make 13.9 grams of calcium oxide. However, it told me up here that 13.1 grams are what are actually produced. So now let's go ahead and use that percent yield equation. Percent yield says that we have the actual amount divided by the theoretical amount, and we multiply that times 100. So we actually made 13.1 divided by theoretically, we should have made 13.9 all times 100. So we end up with a percent yield of 94.2%. Which is a pretty good percent yield. That's pretty high. Here's another example. What is the percent yield if 4.65 grams of copper is produced when 1.87 grams of aluminum reacts in excess of copper sulfate? Excess means we don't really have to think about it. We've got extra. It's like extra vinegar to our baking soda. We're putting in more than enough. So the only thing we need to think about in this case is the aluminum and how much copper we're going to make. So plug it into the stoich problem. Here's the amount of aluminum we start with. Convert grams into moles. Balance chemical formula, moles of aluminum to moles of copper. And you should finish off with 6.61 grams of copper. This is what you theoretically should make. So 6.61 grams is the theoretical amount. From the problem, 4.65 grams is what you started with. 4.65 divided by 6.61 times 100 gives me a 70.3% yield.